The United Nations has made education a priority. In its Agenda 2030, Goal 4 calls for inclusive and equitable quality education and lifelong learning opportunities for all. Will this goal ever come true in your country? The Yidan Prize has commissioned the Economist Intelligence Unit to figure it out. This is the story of our predictions that will redefine the future of education in 25 economies. In 2015, Norway invested as much as 9% of GDP on public education expenditure, but the percentage in Nigeria was only 0.7%. High-income economies are expected to decrease their government expenditures on education. By 2030, Norway's public education expenditure will only account for 6.4% of GDP. But in low-income economies such as India, it is estimated to increase its public education expenditure from 4.1% of GDP in 2015 to 4.8% of GDP in 2030. However, high public education expenditure does not guarantee affordable education. In India, a four-year degree at university will still cost more than double the average income per person. Even in a developed economy such as the United States, it will rank the fifth most unaffordable in terms of university education after India. And a university degree no longer promises you a job. Finland, which offers the fifth most affordable university education among 25 economies, is also the economy with the sixth highest youth unemployment rate. To fill the skill gap between education and job market, some economies have introduced STEM programs. In less than 15 years from now, new STEM graduates in Russia are expected to account for 1.4% of the labor force, the highest on the list. At the same time, the youth unemployment rate could hit 22.5% of the total labor force in 2030. What will the future hold? Are we ready for 2030? Get the full picture on EdenPrize.org.